But of course, Bondi is a fur seal, so it's in the water where those flippers really work. Now what you're seeing here is known as bowing or porpoising, and it's a very energy efficient way for many marine animals to move through the water, catching a quick breath of air every time they leap. This allows them to keep up their terrific speed while chasing down prey or even escaping from a predator. Now of course, seals are one of the most dominant predators in our oceans, but there is another one that Bondi is too familiar with. It's super important for a healthy ocean, but it's sometimes misunderstood. Bondi, do you want to give us a hint on what that is, buddy? Shout it out if you know what that is. A shark. Absolutely adorable, fluffy shark impersonation there from Bonds. But what you're actually seeing there is another natural behavior known as sailing. You see, fur seals like Bondi are covered in a double layer of fur. And this fur is so good at keeping their heat in that it's only their naked, hairless flippers that let any of the heat back out again. So on a hot summer's day, all Bondi has to do is stick a flipper. At the moment, Pepper is learning something known as a spin, and that's where he'll just eventually leap out of the water and spin in the air. Pepper also knows a behavior known as a flip, and that's where he does a very common backflip in the water. Because these behaviors are so similar, oftentimes Pepper gets confused between the two of them and does one when the other is cute.
Now this is Waru, and even with her beak and feet, she needs help to get inside the emu egg, and the rock is the perfect tool for the job. Come on. That just is not helping your cause, my friend. Now she's making a little bit of a hole there. She'll try and pull it apart. Hopefully that'll be enough to get you in there. There we go, success. We got there in the end. Now we do tend to associate tool use like this with humans and other primates, and I think that's why it's kind of cool to see a bird like Waru achieve his goal. And I think it goes to show that we definitely have a lot more in common with birds than what many people first thought.